The whole situation is crazy.
Very difficult situation.
Whoa. What?
I don't know if we...
The whole situation is absolutely fucking crazy down there in Washington.
No.
Oh, no. Watch that.
Pure lunacy.
Stop. Oh. Watch that.
I don't know if we
language.
Use...
The C word.
Yeah, I don't think we, on this channel, I don't think we use that word.
Don't use the C word.
They're absolutely mentally ill down there in Washington.
Now we are talking
about a crazy situation.
Just because no end in sight. What's next? Just dropping N-bombs like a madman? What are you doing?
Just because it's an XL channel doesn't mean you have to disregard everybody's feelings.
I feel like exactly. There's a whole me mentality going on down there in Washington.
Oh, Jesus
with
Christ.
With this whole government shutdown thing.
Oh, no.
You don't see it as a crazy situation?
I don't use that word.
I don't use that word either. There's sensitivity.
What? Yeah. What are you talking
anti-bullying.
About?
Anti-bullying.
What? What's happening? Did I miss something?
Why not just say fucking, you know, use the R word or the N word?
Right.
It's called the C word.
The C word?
Yeah.
We got the C word.
That's been replaced.
The C word's been replaced.
Yes.
Yes, we've totally eliminated that C word because it's much too offensive.
Oh. You don't even say the C word for the C word anymore?
No.
It's just a bad word?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's no place for that. You just say this situation is out of the ordinary.
Out of the ordinary? No, it's absolutely fucking crazy.
Don't.
We have a government that has shut down.
Mm.
That's fucking nuts.
Come on.
Can you say nuts?
No, absolutely not. It implies C.
Crazy.
Oh, but I don't use that word.
I don't either.
I don't use that word.
I don't even sing it like, for being so.
Yeah.
Going out to the rails on the train. See, that's what I do.
Yeah, me too.
What? You don't say crazy anymore? Why? What happened?
Jesus.
What happened?
It offends certain.
What?
Peoples and groups.
There's a group. Well, is it really a group?
I've heard one representative.
Oh, okay.
What's going on?
Oh my God, I was reading some.
I must
tweets.
Say, I think I had a brilliant setup there.
Oh man,
I have to tear down the wall today.
You did, but I got to say, also, setup. Sam Roberts picked right up on it.
It's a brilliant setup.
I didn't. I guess I'm insensitive. What happened?
Someone has a problem with the word crazy, huh?
Yeah. Yep.
I hear that was a big issue yesterday on the Ron and Fish.
That's where the issue did pop up.
I was reading some tweets.
Is this our Jocktober?
Look.
Is this the first Jocktober? It's going to feature... What?
Are we featuring Fez on Jocktober?
This really...
Oh my God.
This fits, is all I'm saying.
Really?
Like is it glove. Kind of a, guys?
A little bit.
Oh no.
A little bit.
Is this the kickoff for Jocktober? It's going to be featuring Fez?
People were calling up the show yesterday.
Wow.
Wondering why Fez decided he had to be the hole.
Oh, boy.
What happened yesterday?
Well, Fez brought to the show's attention that there's a commercial for Chevrolet.
Right.
That uses the word crazy irresponsibly.
And he has a problem with the word crazy.
He was deeply offended by the commercial.
What?
Do you want to... Maybe we should play the commercial. I don't know if you want to take a break or you want to play the commercial.
I think we got to take a break.
We got to take a break and then we should kick off Jocktober.
With Fez?
Now, here's the thing.
Oh, no.
You guys may see the commercial.
Or is this bonus Jocktober?
Oh, man.
I'm going to tell you something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a full Jocktober prepared outside of the Fez situation.
Bonus Jocktober.
That's right.
Is Fez doing a bit?
No.
Oh, jeez.
This is not a bit. He's actually mad at the word crazy.
Like,
can you say mad?
Mad. Mm. Mad in England, it means crazy.
Right.
Yes, I don't know if you want
to. He's positively mad.
Like, Ron, yeah. Ron voiced being, like, scared yesterday.
Wow.
Really?
Like, Ron was like, this is freaking me out.
Wow, that takes a lot.
Yeah.
Because Ronnie doesn't fucking.
I just fucking rolls with the punches.
Exactly.
That Ron Bennington.
But I mean,
he wasn't rolling as much yesterday, huh?
He didn't know what was going on.
Really?
However, at the same time, you guys have not seen the commercial that's being questioned. You guys may be deeply offended by the commercial as well.
You know what?
I'm deeply
fair enough.
I'm deeply offended by the fucking Cheerios commercial that Ann brought to our attention.
That is.
Because guess what? I wouldn't want to have Cheerios with my Nana.
Nana. Yeah.
One of my nanas was a complete and utter crazy lunatic.
Oh, wow.
Who yelled and screamed at little fucking kids.
Insensitivity.
When Nana came over, we didn't have Cheerios with her. Know why? We were hiding in closets upstairs.
You know what are good? Honey Nut Cheerios. Like Honey Nut?
I like the Honey Nut. I like the multigrain. You know, I don't like the regular Cheerios.
No, we call them, Honey Crunch Cheerios.
Oh, okay.
We're going to go Honey Crunch from now on.
You don't like the word nut?
We don't say that like that.
All right.
It can be misconstrued.
Sorry. Oh, I see. Envy. Oh, I missed. Sorry. Fuck. Jesus Christ. It's my bit and I fucking forgot. Right. I've got my own bit. I thought you were actually just talking about the different varieties of Cheerios.
Of course. I was. I didn't even realize.
I'm on double patrol picking up these setups.
Oh, you certainly are.
It's go to a fucking seasonal allergies. Yes, I have an excuse. I'm in another fucking world trying to figure out the combination of drugs to take so fucking my body doesn't kill me.
Hope he needs like an AIDS cocktail kind of concoction.
It's a nightmare.
Would you really hide in the closet when your grandma came over?
Oh, God.
I used closet, but wherever we could find a place to hide.
Is the closet offensive too? I haven't figured that out yet.
We all hid.
Even though he means literally, he was hiding in the closet. Not like
I pumped up the story. We went upstairs to our rooms and stayed in our rooms when Nana was over with a box of Cheerios wondering who's going to eat with her.
Yeah. Nobody was coming downstairs for breakfast?
No, because that could mean the whole bowl of Cheerios was going to be dumped on your head because you were an excited kid about something.
It's like we're having Cheerios with Nana.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Fuck Nana.
I hate that dumbass fuck commercial. Don't try tugging at my heartstrings.
I'm talking about the Nana that called me precious and I walked out on her deathbed. That Nana.
Precious.
Never have Cheerios with her.
Yes.
My other Nana, we just called her Grandma. Yeah, I would have Cheerios with her.
You would. Grandma and a Nana too.
Yeah.
I had a Grandma and a Nana. Was your Nana your dad's
No,
sister
my
or your mom's?
My dad's mom was the coolest chick.
Was grandma?
Ever. She ruled.
See, my mom's mom was grandma, and my dad's mom was Nana.
Oh no, she didn't. The other one didn't even want to be called Grandma, Nana, or any of that shit.
Really?
What'd you call her?
I don't Miss B or something.
No way.
Yeah.
You called her Miss?
Like something like that. Yeah, I forget now.
Like a formal name.
Yeah, B was the first initial of her.
Not like
last
Aunt B.
Name.
That would be a
wasn't
ironic.
Aunt B because it was a grandma. So yeah. I forgot it was like Mrs. B or something. We hated her.
Ew.
We openly hated her.
This is your grandmother, and the name that you're giving her is what you would call a substitute teacher.
That's real.
Like that's the
that's
emotional
real loving,
closeness.
Right? That's loving and close.
Right.
Ew. Well, fuck her.
Yeah, fuck her.
Yeah.
I had no
Cheerios.
Relationship with her. She super. Yeah. Told all the stories. She sued my mom when we were all little kids because my mom and dad needed a little loan.
Sue
and
everyone.
They weren't paying back my mom's mom fast enough, so my mom's mom decided she has to sue her own daughter that has 6, 7, possibly 9 kids at home, depending on what year it was.
Depending on what's in the attic.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Judge Koch would throw that case out.
Fuck yeah.
So to the credit, my mom's credit, she blew off her own mom because she knew it was an unhealthy situation. And then, I was in my 20s when she was dying in a hospital bed somewhere. And I went and saw her because my mom was saying goodbye. And that's when she goes, Precious, Precious.
Don't try to make up now.
And
lady.
I go, Mom, I'll, do it. I basically said something like this. Do what you have to do. I'll see you outside. Never acknowledged that this lady was calling me Precious.
Ugh. Wow. This lady.
Yeah. We had no fucking connection. My mom's sister. I haven't seen in 30 years. She lives in Queens.
Wow.
Queens is 15 minutes
it
away.
It is kind of far.
You think so? Yeah.
I literally haven't seen my mom's fucking sister in 30 years. She lives a mere 15 miles from here.
God,
fucking
damn.
Pure craziness on that side.
Crazy. I don't know if you want to go that far.
So anyway, we're going to do the crazy commercial after the break, and then we're going to do the Fez crazy shit.
Yes.
Nice.
It's shit, right? It's stupidity.
Oh, boy.
I'm going to let you guys be the judge.
What happened to him?
I don't know, dude.
Isn't he part of an edgy radio show where you kind of try to have an open mind about everything?
That's the idea.
When you start banning words and this and that, you're kind of closing your
especially when the
your
word,
surroundings.
Well, when the word is crazy.
He's got a cause now. It's like in the old days, it wasn't, he's a little more socially active these days. But although I read some tweets from people going, stop complaining and trying to ban words, and if you really mean it, go out in the community and do something. You know, volunteer at an animal hospital or help the mentally ill or something, instead of just, you know, getting on the air and criticizing words. But, you know, maybe it takes a while to get up to speed.
Who knows? That's weird. That's a weird cause to take on. What, he wants to ban the word crazy?
I think so.
He doesn't. He wants people to be outraged against Chevrolet. Because of the...
Oh, that'll work out well for Ron and Fez.
Yeah.
That's good. Way to go, Fez.
Who needs automobile sponsors?
Right, way to put your partner in a tough situation, going after a fucking car dealership. When that whole industry is dying, that's good. That's great.
See the USA in your Chevrolet.
Yeah.
That's what I say.
No. They use terrible words in their commercials.
All right.
Hey, look what I got for breakfast today.
What is it? I see a banana. Oh, I see some multigrain Cheerios.
Multigrain.
Wow.
So it's like you're eating with Nana.
Oh, God. Oh, do you see that look? He didn't like
yeah,
that.
Was venom.
See, I like blacks.
What?
Huh?
I like black people. That's why I eat multigrain.
What?
Oh, it's like multicultural.
I guarantee there's a bit out there where I just know. And I swear to God, I'm not pulling this out of my ass. I bet you someone did a bit or some kind of fucking survey or whatever where the cereal you eat says a lot about you.
Oh, I'm sure.
Look it up.
I'm certain of it. Yeah.
We're going to break here, but we're going to get into some crazy shit after the break. And I guarantee that.
Jesus Christ.
To the people.
The Opie and Anthony Show on SiriusXM.
Opie and Anthony.
How you doing, everybody?
I guess this will be the last time we're allowed to play Crazy Train.
Yeah, that's...
Now that Fez is running the channel.
Can we get a radio edit of this song?
Yeah, we should... Can they reverse the word crazy?
Yeah.
Rails on this Yuga train.
Can we turn this into Crazy Day?
No.
We like our themes on this show.
Songs with crazy.
Songs with crazy.
There it is. No. Crazy day.
All right, Travis. Travis on the board. Crazy. I notice a lot things are a lot tighter.
I'm going today. Crazy. Crazy.
Hey, ladies.
There's a lot of...
There are the girls.
Hi, girls.
Hi, girls.
That's the morning mashup.
What?
It's three men and one woman.
I didn't even see a woman. I mean, you know, I saw three girls. What happened to the real girl? She wasn't with them.
No?
No.
Maybe she's hungover.
Do you need...
All right, here's the deal. Fez, I don't know, he's taking up another cause. Another silly cause.
I guess we got to see the commercial that started it all.
Yeah, but you know what?
Yeah?
I was thinking during the whole fucking commercial break there. Yeah. I was just thinking.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be done.
It's Jocktober. A celebration of all things shitty in radio.
Is that very nice?
Fantastic failures of pontificating proportions.
That's so bad.
Wow.
An interactive exploration of what makes radio rancid.
No.
Jocktober.
OMG.
Hosts, polls, bits, and stunt boys.
This isn't funny.
It's time for Jock. October.
I got a tree on my house.
Wow. No. I cannot believe we're kicking off Jocktober. It seems like just a year ago we were doing the same thing.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. But we're kicking it off with our own Ron and Fez show.
Whoa.
I can't I can't say that.
I can't do that to Ron.
Well, I'm saying with the Ron and Fez show, but yeah.
It's elements. Because you'll hear, the show handles this well.
Oh, okay. All right.
Okay.
We're focusing on Fez. I can't do it. I can't do that to Ron.
So it's officially we're featured.
Yes, yes.
Kickoff of Jocktober.
Yes.
By the way, this is a bonus Jocktober.
This is a bonus Jocktober. We actually have another Jocktober.
This is not an attack.
We're going to start off strong today. We're going to do two.
This is not an attack. This was not preconceived. I've been working on Jocktober for a month.
Oh, yeah.
I've been working since August on Jocktober. Yesterday, as I was finalizing today's Jocktober, I was listening to the Ron and Fez show.
This happened.
And I thought, on any day, we would bring this to the attention of you guys.
Sure.
Right.
And you guys were getting tweets about it, so you were asking me what's going on with Ron and Fez.
All of a sudden, Twitter blew up with talking about Fez and Ronnie and all the people from the Ron and Fez show going off on this topic.
It's crazy.
I mean, it was
unexpected.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Insane.
No, that's not good either.
So I guess during the Ron and Fez show, they played a commercial for Chevrolet.
Yeah. So do you want to?
I'm a huge fan of Chevrolet.
By the way, this was not.
Ow.
This commercial was not.
Fuck.
Broadcast on the radio.
No. Oh, really?
This is a commercial that Fez saw on TV.
Oh, and was offended.
And was so deeply offended that he had to come to the show and bring it up.
Right.
That's good.
You like that?
I'm sure the audio is not making the rounds of the corporate office at Chevrolet. This is the reason why we continue to have cum products advertising with us. So that's all we could get. We used to have car companies, right?
Cars,
beers.
See, we also do the commercial thing. We point out the silly commercials on TV, but his angle is so different than ours.
Right?
I don't want to have fucking Cheerios with a dead Nana.
No.
I
leave a box on the stoop for Lee and Morty.
But you guys have less of a problem with Cheerios and more of a problem with grandmas.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, apparently so.
Yeah. I think...
Morty, do you hear me, Morty?
With Time Warner Cable.
Yeah.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
I can't buy into the Time Warner thing because the acting is so bad by Bill Cowher.
Yeah.
But his angle is very different. He doesn't like the word crazy in the Chevrolet commercial.
No. Do you want to see the
judge?
Yes, of course.
We'll be the judge. Maybe we won't even do this Jocktober, bonus Jocktober, because we'll see the commercial and go, oh, okay, I agree.
Yeah, right. Sam, why would you bring this to our attention?
Right.
This could be a Jim Chandler situation. Where we realized the show wasn't bad.
Is that what we realized?
Yes, we did. Yeah, that's exactly what we realized, Sam Roberts.
A little revisionist, but okay.
We're almost talking, me and Jim Chandler.
Oh, wow.
Almost.
It's kind of like Washington. We're waiting to... Someone's got to make the first move.
Someone's got to make the first move.
We're getting there, right?
We're getting there. Yeah, we're following each other's shit.
How are his tweets?
You know, they're good.
Yeah?
Yeah, I like following Jim Chandler.
Oh.
Down there in Nashville. I think he's into Guad, though.
Oh, really?
He had a Guad tweet.
Does he have a personal relationship with Jesus?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure how deep he goes with the Guad.
With Jesus.
With Jesus.
All right, so you want to see the...
You want to know what we did?
What?
Ooh.
It's beautiful. Kid party. Jesus party. All on the same day.
Wait, what? How does that work?
Who else has done that in their lives?
Perfect.
What is that?
I got a daughter turning one, and she's still not... part of the Jesus.
Not part of Jesus?
So we're doing it all in one day.
How do you do that?
How much does that rock?
What,
you do
like
one less party.
You do the christening before the birthday party.
All in one day.
Oh, you're doing a christening thing?
Oh, yeah.
Dunking that kid?
You go to a church and you do the right thing?
Yeah.
Private christening.
Peel off the fucking bills.
Private
That's the good thing about the church. You pay them enough, they'll do anything.
So we get to do it all in one day.
Private.
Nice, right?
Nice.
Am I the greatest relative ever?
You don't need to answer that. You need that.
But I saved everyone a fucking party.
Exactly.
Because I know everyone doesn't want to go to these fucking family parties over and over again. You do a kid party, next thing you know, you got to come back up for a christening. Let's do it all in one.
Smart.
Nice, right?
It's considerate is what it is.
Birthday cake, we'll have a little cross like down low. Just so people know, okay, this is the cake is for the Jesus as well.
Yeah, keep it Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus.
No one from my family's going, though.
And forgive us for trespasses. We forgive those trespasses. Forgive us for trespasses. We forgive those trespasses. That's what church sounds like.
You realize in church that a lot of people have problems with S words.
Oh, God.
The whole fucking church is a buzz when it gets to that word.
I was never able to, like, that was always so distracting. You get a room full of people blurting out a bunch of S's in a row like that.
That's what it sounds like.
Trespasses.
Forgive us for trespasses. We forgive those trespasses.
Oh, I hate church.
Oh, it's so boring.
Even adding in the second party into the first party, your family's still not going?
No.
Why?
No. I thought that would get people motivated.
It didn't work.
No, man, it's the second child thing.
Yeah.
All right.
First kid, when he turned one, holy fuck, I had to turn down people. There were so many people that wanted it.
Velvet rope, bouncer.
Oh, I turned down some people. Not this time.
No way.
I might have to invite some casuals because, you know, we rented a restaurant. Got to fill up that joint, so I might start inviting the casuals.
Oh, yeah. Why don't you start some on-air plugs? Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
I'll get them there. I need some asses in seats here, people.
Yeah, exactly. You know, everyone has their excuses why they can't go.
Oh, boy. Mm.
It's a shame.
Yeah, well, maybe they just are offended by the Jesus thing.
No, that
Any
was,
juice?
That was the add-on.
Jews don't believe in Jesus.
Mm. They believe he existed. They just don't believe he's the Son of God.
They'll fucking believe when they're burning in hell.
That's right.
I'll tell you that much. They'll believe then.
You think so?
Fuck yeah.
Do you go to hell for having dreams where you rape people and then fly away?
No, it's dreamy rape. Rape is fine.
Well, let's get into the Fez thing.
All right.
That was a little aside we just did there.
Beautiful aside, by the way.
I've been reading Stop Stalling.
They want it, huh?
Oh, do they fucking want it?
Sometimes I feel like we're on regular radio still, and we got to eat up those quarter hours. It's called eating up those quarter hours.
Like Langoliers.
Yeah, man. I mean, the one thing, you know, we give credit when credit's due. Howard was brilliant at eating up the quarter hours.
Mm-hmm.
He was very good at eating up the quarter hours. We did pretty well in our own right, eating up those quarter hours.
What's that, when you stall until...
You keep stalling knowing you got a little nugget, and they have to listen longer, and then they have to fucking write your name down in the Arbitron diaries.
The diaries.
Like, fucking listen to them for 2 weeks just so they would get to 1 minute of audio.
And they realized those diaries were a lump of shit.
Yeah, they were.
Came out with the electronic monitoring and realized people were listening for 2 seconds. Yeah. And they put down 15 minutes.
Anthony, 2 p.m. to 7 p.m.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
So here's the deal. Fez decided to talk yesterday.
And
oh, boy.
He has a problem with a commercial that isn't even on our channel.
Mm-hmm. No, it's a television
TV commercial.
We go after commercials ourselves, like I said. And it was this Chevrolet commercial that I swear to you, I don't think I've seen yet.
No, and I'm big on commercials and big on picking out things on commercials. I love commercials. This, I wouldn't even give this a second thought as being offensive.
Okay.
Although I got to see it, really. I'm speculating here. Let's see it.
All right.
The Chevy Cruze offers an EPA estimated 36 mpg highway. That's crazy. Crazy efficient. 10 standard airbags. And you get Stabilitrack with traction control. That is like crazy protection. Mm. This interior is insane. It is insane. I was going to say crazy again.
Visit your local Chevy dealer today. Right now, get this great lease on a 20.
Oh, my God. I'm so offended.
You are, right?
He stopped a brilliant radio show for this?
Wait, did you notice how many times she used the word?
Yeah.
You did.
That was the joke, I guess.
Right.
I'm offended there wasn't one tart or spook in the whole commercial.
Yeah, that was the commercial.
That.
Yeah, he didn't like the way they used the word crazy. He said it was offensive crazy to those people who are mentally ill.
They won't notice. They're crazy.
Crazy's been around my entire life.
Oh, boy.
And I've been called crazy. And
does it hurt?
Not in the fucking least. Oh. Not in the fucking least.
You didn't find that commercial offensive?
Holy shit.
Well, apparently Fez did.
And we got clips?
Yeah, we got some clips. The first clip is Ron and Shelby, who's the intern.
Who the fuck is Shelby?
He used to be an intern, and now he's a special guest.
Shelby's hilarious.
He's great, dude.
I was listening to the show, and this Shelby got a weird little midget voice.
Yep.
But very informed, very big on pop culture, movies, things like that. Bounces off of Ronnie. And
quite hilarious.
Is he replacing the other two guys, Chris and Stanley?
No, Chris Pepper Hicks Stanley is just one man. A lot of people get confused.
That's four guys right there.
So wait.
Chris Pepper Hicks and Stanley?
So is Pepper Hicks throwing his voice through a special processing thing to sound different so he's now Shelby?
Oh, is he Shelby too?
Oh, he's Shelby.
Oh, you know what? I fell for that.
Ron's brilliant.
Hey,
so it's the same guy, but now you throw it through a few filters and now it looks like he's working with someone new.
That's incorrect. There's Ron Bennington, who we all know and love.
Call me Shelby.
There's Shelby.
Shelby.
Who used to be Pepper Hicks before they changed his voice to make it higher. And then all right.
How does Inside Dave fit into all this?
Well, he has left the
and
show.
And the Stanley Chris guys are what? More behind the scenes?
Now, Chris Pepper Hicks Stanley is his own man.
Oh.
Yep.
Yeah, I'll never understand
did Shelby
at all.
Eat the fucking cereal?
That's a great question.
Mm-hmm. Someone did.
All right, so this is Fez or Shelby or...
Well, Ron and Shelby are talking about SNL.
So...
And then Fez brings up the commercial and they watch it and...
Oh, boy.
And this is where Ron goes like, what the fuck is going on?
Ron finally loses his mind.
I've been waiting for this day. Go ahead.
Is this a bit or not? Like, you knew it was a bit, but the way he played it was he was like a man in the street that was doing these like awkward...
Pause.
...interviews at...
Is that Fez?
That's Shelby.
That's little Shelby.
Wait, maybe they're reinventing Fez with the Shelby character, because that sounded sort of like Fez if you sped up his voice a little bit.
Well,
I hate to pull the curtain back, but Shelby is also his own man.
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
Yeah. Just motocross places or the
beach.
Oh,
I think I saw that, yeah.
Just poorly produced. You didn't know.
And there would be long, fucking uncomfortable silences.
Yeah, and he'd just try to touch them or... Just mumble. It was crazy. But yeah, now he's on SNL.
Crazy.
Have you seen the commercial that keeps using the word?
Holy
Oh there it is.
I would so be out of radio.
Oh my God.
You couldn't put up with it?
No.
That is hilarious. So they said crazy.
And I have to stress no, because I put up with this shit most of my life. So no, I would not be able to put up with it on a radio show.
Yeah.
No, there's no fucking way.
Kind of reminded Fez of the commercial.
Right.
That well, he was offended that happens, by.
You know, I see how the thinking works.
Ronnie said crazy.
I love when Fez comes in with something. Like, when that thought is starting.
Gangbusters.
Hey!
Yeah, yeah.
Have you seen? Like, he jumped in there.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Crazy.
Have you seen the commercial that keeps using the word crazy? Played all day yesterday from Chevrolet. I can't believe nobody. I looked it up. I go, this Chevrolet can't possibly be using this commercial with nobody complaining about it.
I don't even know what you're talking about.
It's the two women in the commercial.
This played during football?
Yeah, it played during football. Played all yesterday. I can play it for you here. It's on the iBang.
Where is it on the iBang? What's it under?
Corporate America. Not as everyone friendly as they think.
Oh, no.
The Chevy Cruze offers an EPA estimated 36 mpg highway. That's crazy.
That's fucking crazy.
10 standard airbags. And you get Stabilitrack with traction control.
That's retarded.
That is like crazy protection. And this interior is
insane.
It is insane. Mm-hmm. I was going to say crazy again.
See your Western New York Chevy dealers. Qualified list.
I'm totally missing
the way that they so glibly throw out the terms crazy and insane throughout this commercial, and no one has picked up on this, that how insulting that is to mental health care and mental health patients.
Oh my God.
I had no idea that's where you were going with
this. Absolutely.
I did not even for a second.
You didn't pick up on it when you heard it? Just how it's just, we're getting beat over the head with it?
We don't sit around and say each other is crazy. We do it constantly. Everyone does it. When you disagree with someone, you say you are crazy.
But I think it's a different thing. I mean, people shouldn't throw the word around so loosely.
When did this happen? I thought we were worried about fag. Now we're worried about crazy?
Yes, we're worried about all of it.
No one's worried about it.
Yeah, that's my point. No one has brought up how this commercial feels to attack insane, mentally ill people.
You'd have to be crazy. Seriously. To be offended by that fucking commercial. I had no idea where your head was on this one.
They just go over it. No, remember?
We don't call each other crazy all the time. Or we don't call each other's opinions crazy.
Yes, we do. But this
do
is
you think being crazy is a good thing?
No.
I am crazy.
And I'm saying.
I get that you don't. I get that you're like, hey, why pick on a race? Or a sexual thing, because they're not crazy. But I think that we can agree that crazy
is crazy.
Is fucking not a good thing to be. And to point out things that are crazy makes sense for normal thinking people.
Normies.
Fucking Ronnie is brilliant. Wow. He feels that.
Wow.
He was blown away.
He was serious.
Yo, yeah.
Fez is serious with these things.
And that other voice that was going, oh my God, that, my friends, and this is Chris Pepper Hicks Stanley. Oh,
I know. This is close to our heart, though. You can't ban words in America.
I can't, like, how could you be on this channel of all places and advocate?
We're trying to fight the good fight over here.
Yeah. Every word is fair game.
It's the only place left where we could talk. This channel.
True. This channel. Can't even talk in public.
No.
Like we talk here.
Every word. Offends people.
Yeah.
Of course.
Almost every word.
Was.
Was and the, maybe not. But every other word.
Yeah. Old people don't like was.
No. Well, why would you call them old people? That's offensive.
Oh, shit.
You can't call people old.
Graying Americans.
You know what old means.
Arthritic Americans.
Did I come off as ageist there?
Yes.
Oh, sorry.
You did.
Gives a fuck.
Shattered hippians. I don't know.
This is, and then I get the tweets from people that go, why are you even doing this? Don't you know Fez is a character? Fez is not a character.
He's not, dude.
And I know that tweet was real. Fez is not a character.
Like Mr. Amos uses characters. By the way, Paul Giamatti, great actor. Every time I see him, though, I just think pig vomit, pig virus, whatever. I can't look at it. He's apparently in a new movie about the Kennedy assassination. He plays this Spruger guy and stuff. And I saw the ad last night, and all I'm thinking is, Nahad. I saw him in fucking Saving Private Ryan. He was so good. He had not a big part in Saving Private Ryan, but he's fucking brilliant in it. And I'm just like, Nahad.
Even in Sideways, when they're going to wineries, I'm like, when does he teach the guy to say the call letter?
Basic. He's brilliant, but I will always see him as that guy.
As that guy.
Yeah.
All right. How many more clips of this?
We have nonsense. Six.
I mean, they get really good.
They went on for a little while.
Okay.
I mean, we can throw in the towel or pick.
Let's hear the second clip. More. And I'm all in so far.
I don't mean to offend athletes when I say throw in the towel. Anybody who's ever had to
throw in the towel
due to injury or otherwise, I apologize.
That's true.
So this is the next clip is Fez talking about corporate America being insensitive.
I think it's very insulting. And when the Burger King commercial
let me see it from the beginning.
Okay.
Because I don't want you to go into a Burger King because I have no idea what that one is either. I don't know that this is a thing. All right, this is up on the iBang and see what is it as?
Corporate America, not as everyone friendly as they think.
I don't know what even that means.
Because corporate America is always saying, no, we're always making sure that we're taking care of the needs of our customers. We're sensitive to
this
people.
This is really nuts.
And this is really insensitive.
Fuck sensitivity.
You're nuts, dude.
Thank you, Ron.
Ronnie called him fucking nuts. Bizarre. Insane, paranoid.
Fuck sensitivity. All right, let's go back. Holy shit.
First of all, I need to white out so I can get back to try to find out. Because if you played this for me a million times, I would say lazy, probably dumb, doesn't really push the product, but insensitive or cruel, no.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ronnie's great. Ronnie, just you're crazy. Yeah. You're insane.
You are nuts.
You are nuts. He lost it on this one.
And it's not. I mean, if Fez is a bit or a character, because I mean, his name is not Fez.
Uh huh.
That's the life he's chosen to live. The character in the bit is not a character. Him as a person. That's him.
It's him.
I don't even want an if in there. He's not a character.
What
okay?
goes on? I don't get to listen to the show as much as I would like because I'm home by the time it comes on. I have to waste an hour listening to some drivel between 10 and 11. And
you're talking about Wednesdays or every day except Wednesday?
Oh, Wednesday I like.
Damn it.
Does he talk about like his personal life, like what he does at night or off the show? Is there...
No, they'll ask him, you know, have you sucked any dick? And he'll go...
Oh, Jesus.
He'll go, no.
But like, there's a line between maybe catching a movie and sucking dick.
Right.
Like there's other things...
Well, he doesn't do stuff. They busted him yesterday.
Yeah.
Because I think he had said he wasn't going to watch the Buccaneers anymore.
Right.
Because of the Trayvon Martin thing.
Wait. What?
Right. Tampa Bay Buccaneers, right? I believe they said because...
What's the law?
What's the law in Florida that everybody
Stand your
hates?
Ground?
Right. Because of the stand your ground thing.
He can't be a Tampa Bay Buccaneers fan anymore.
Watch the Bucs anymore. And then they busted him because they got him to admit he was watching them on a laptop. And then he said it was because they're... going to look at Stand Your Ground. They're going to look at it again.
Holy mother of God.
You're joking, right?
No, dude.
If he's pulling a work, it's brilliant.
He's not, though.
If he's pulling a work, it's a 7-year work.
It's a 7-year work. Yeah.
All right, let's go.
All right.
Okay, this is... he's surprised that there aren't more groups speaking up against this commercial.
Because they're too crazy to know that it's even going on.
And they're not even crazy enough to be offended by it.
Right. Yes.
I don't get it. I don't get how you could be offended by that.
Well, first of all, I'm offended that Chevrolet would think it's okay to keep using those words over and over again.
We use those words over and over again on this show. You do too.
And I'm more offended by mental health groups not calling them out on this. Why are they letting this thing go by?
Your fucking eyes.
Because they're too busy dealing with crazy people.
At that point, this is you leaving Earth. It's done now.
I was shocked when I saw this yesterday, and I'm sure it played all day Saturday too.
You're shocked because you think your toaster is trying to kill you. Oh my God, that takes wacky to a whole new level.
Wacky. That's not a good word either.
Mm-mm.
Can't say wacky,
that
right?
That means
it harkens
crazy.
Back to
to crazy.
Yeah.
You think it's going to be awkward in the halls today?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fez will probably blame me for this whole thing.
Will he?
He's done it before.
Whatever.
He's blamed you?
Oh, yeah.
Who else has taken the brunt of Fez's blame around here for things?
Who's Fez been angry at on the show?
Yeah, Opie, right?
Yeah, but usually if Opie will say something...
Why are you mad at me?
When Opie takes his shots at Fez,
right?
Fez likes to act like I'm like...
Well, why is he mad at me?
Because you take a lot of shots at him.
No, I don't.
All the time.
Because you're the catalyst.
Yeah.
Yeah, Fez thinks that like I'm putting him up to it, when in reality it's because he doesn't want to fight with Opie, so, you know.
Oh, okay.
look, he's offended, right?
Oh, yeah.
But to this day, he's done the most offensive thing around here.
And what's that?
And trust me, I didn't even care when he did that.
Uh-huh. What did he do?
He walked around here as Hitler. With a real Hitler mustache, not one you could go buy.
You're right, he did do that.
I don't think you could be more offensive than that.
Do you think that's offensive, though?
But now you fast forward a few years and he has a problem with the word crazy? It takes a crazy person to walk around as Hitler.
And then he walked through Times Square with a real Hitler mustache, wearing only a diaper. And pronounced
Just funny.
He pronounced himself as Baby Hitler.
Baby Hitler.
And he gelled his hair to the side.
Yeah, yeah, like Hitler.
But that's the subtleness of like over the top offensive and then funny.
Right.
Baby Hitler.
Baby Hitler.
Not many people are going to deny. That's funny.
However.
But coming in here as Hitler, completely dressed as Hitler.
You think some Jewish
people in uniform
and
everything.
Yeah, didn't he bombard the show one day in uniform?
Yes.
As Hitler?
Yes.
Do you think some Jewish people might be offended by that?
He did. I forgot.
Sam,
showed up in uniform and bombarded the show as Hitler.
I refer to my Hitler video that I made back in the day on my YouTube channel, Opie Radio.
Wow, Opster, that's a classic.
You got some serious tweeting to do today.
I sure do.
Damn.
Because when it's talked about on the show, I got to tweet those videos out. I'm serious.
Yeah, I totally forgot.
Aside,
that's like on the MeTV version of your YouTube. It's like all the classic shows.
Yeah. So you got,
oh my God.
All right. This is the same guy that now has a problem with the word crazy.
It's here.
You did not come to work like that.
This is not work. This is a mission!
Fezzy has arrived from the Ron and Fez show dressed up exactly like Hitler, if Hitler was really fat.
Casual Hitler.
Oh, God. Wearing
jeans.
Did you say Hitler was really fat?
What?
Oh, my goodness.
What? That's a problem now.
I don't think so, but I think it's funny.
Okay.
Wow.
It's kind of, but he does have a brown shirt on and a nice tie.
He looks like Al Hitler.
And your hair is you got the Hitler hair, not only the mustache now.
Some people are just blessed with the good genes.
Oh, the genes. Oh, I see.
Herr Watley is here to invite you to a party?
Yeah, oh, a party.
National Socialist Party.
He just did the Hitler salute.
Yeah, he raised his arms.
Yeah, yeah, he did the Hitler salute. And the curtains aren't closed, so any Jew that passed by would...
He walked around the
halls. No, he walked around like that all day.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
You know, I know of a guy that did some controversial things on our show, and I want him to look at this to see how it, stacks up. Troy Kwan needs to...
No. Oh, he's seen it. He knows. He doesn't feel one way or the other about it, to tell you the truth.
But he almost got fired for saying some outrageous things.
He doesn't even...
And Fez is now...
This ain't even on his radar.
You sure?
Yeah, he doesn't feel... He knows it happened. He doesn't feel one way or the other.
Oh, we could do
20 minutes on that.
Tell you the truth, it'll just be boring. Don't even worry about it.
We could eat up a quarter hour
No. It'll be boring. He doesn't have an opinion.
Let me hear more Fez. As Hitler.
Oh, I was about to say.
And then we'll go back to what he did yesterday.
Do you want to hear Fez offended by the word crazy or Fez dressed up and talking like Hitler?
he's out of his mind about the word crazy in a commercial. We just want to remind Fez that maybe he shouldn't take on these causes.
Well, but what was this, 10 years ago? Or?
In all fairness, probably 2 years, maybe three. Three years, maybe.
At most.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
September 24th.
Yeah, the date. 9
Oh.
24
Oh,
9
Oh, okay.
Oh, 4 years ago.
Hey. Stout NYC.
Right around now.
Broadcast for the Ron and Fez show.
I will be attending, by the way.
We need you, Brother Kumia.
I will attend. I enjoy everything you do.
As we put the Reich back together.
What?
Brother Kumia, Brother Anthony, Brother Joe. Italy, Germany.
Right, we were pals at one point.
Reunited as it should be.
As it should be. You're absolutely right.
Herr Hughes, you will be there?
Hell no.
Yeah.
I just...
Jim Norton, you are an uninvited guest to the party.
Oh.
A to the H was watching TV last night.
Yeah, A to the H.
Sam Robertson, not invited.
Oh, don't make him furious.
is this, pause. Is can this legal?
Can I point out that Ant's wearing the exact same shirt as
I'm dressed as the same video as I was 4 years ago?
It's just that the mustache is missing now.
Yes.
You went through the mustache stage.
Yes,
but you're
I
wearing
did.
The exact same shirt.
I'm wearing the same little 5'11 army shirt. Yeah, yeah. I'm not saying I'm a fashion plate, you know.
Is there more to this video? I didn't.
Eh, it's probably the same stuff. We should maybe go back.
Fair enough. So,
yeah.
There's Fez dressed up as Hitler for the day with the authentic Hitler mustache.
Now, while you...
But he has a problem with the word crazy in a car ad.
You remind Fez that he once dressed up as Hitler and came in here and spoke like Hitler. In this clip, Ron reminds Fez of a commercial that was very famous for a very long time.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. And I do want to say again, I don't give a fuck if he walks around here as Hitler.
Of course not.
That's my point. But the guy that does that probably should have more of an open mind about the word crazy in a commercial.
I think, like, if they would have showed people that they came up and they're, like, wearing, like, robes and they're spitting and drooling down their face, and then they said, you can't buy this car. You're crazy. You don't belong here. You're a crazy person and should be taken out of society. I might be able to say, well, I can see that or how why that would offend some people. But saying a deal is so good that it's crazy and insane, we've done that forever. Remember the guy that used to sell the fucking...
It's Crazy Eddie?
Yeah. My price is so low, it's insane. We're going crazy.
I gotta go get those deals.
Yeah, and you're like, those fucking speakers. $8
yeah.
for speakers that will last through one song? I gotta get them.
Crazy Eddie, that's true.
Right, yeah. Of course.
Yeah. Crazy Eddie.
Made a living off the word crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
And then Ron starts reminding Fez of songs that have the word crazy in the title.
Uh-huh.
And Fez says something that invalidates some of his
art. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Why? Because he likes one of the crazy songs?
No, it's phrasing.
Okay.
It doesn't really make sense to what he's saying.
All right.
Alrighty.
Now, when the Burger King...
Do you know how many fucking songs are called crazy? Willie Nelson had a big song by that. CeeLo had a big song like that. Seal had a big song like that. Beyonce had Crazy in Love. You're fucking nuts, dude. Seriously, your paranoia is frightening me right now.
Those are also just, those are artists. This is a corporation that's supposed to be.
Why do you care? It's supposed to be what? Selling cars.
That's supposed to be friendly to Americans of all kind.
No, you're not. Crazy is not a kind. It's not an ethnic group. It's something that can happen to some people, and then you get meds to get out of being crazy. You don't settle in and become happily crazy the way you have.
I'm proud to be crazy.
You're not a crazy American. As a crazy American.
No.
Our people have brought so much to this country.
This needs help.
Oh, my God.
I don't want my daughter bringing home one of those crazy people. If they did the same commercial, and I don't like to use this word, but inserted the word...
Don't say the N-word.
No, I'm not.
Because
I'm not. If they put in, this interior, it's retarded, people would be going insane.
You know what?
And I don't like to use that word.
I thought of it, and yet you did.
He just said insane.
Right. He had no problem.
He just said insane.
People would go insane.
He just said it.
And he said that people would go insane.
That doesn't make any sense.
See how easy and natural it is to just use that word as the...
Oh, boy.
And you should be able to say this interior is retarded. Because we all know what that means, too.
That's retarded.
Retarded meaning really good way.
Oh, it's retarded.
We used that word in a good way growing up.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, that's retarded, man.
Oh, yeah.
If somebody's insane,
yeah,
they need to be locked up.
Right.
Because they can't function in a society.
They're insane.
Now, is that me saying I am anti-insane Americans?
You are.
And, you know, Fez proved on our point here. We don't want any words fucking banned.
None.
Not a one.
No.
And this is what we said with the nappy-headed hoes and the N-word. We said when they get the N-word, they're going to go for the other word. And I think faggot was the second word. And then they got rid of midget and they got rid of retard.
Jeez.
All those words now are taboo.
Yeah.
In most social circles. Certainly on in mainstream media.
Oh,
you can't
God,
say any of those words anymore.
None of them.
So now if we take fucking Fez's lead, then we add crazy to that list.
Yeah, do you know?
And then they don't stop there. That's the problem.
No, they keep going.
That's why you got to say no to all this shit.
When you start hanging out with somebody new, that's like the mark. You know that you're real friends because after you hang out like five times,
yeah.
Then they can use the word retarded around you.
Yeah.
And you go, oh, okay, cool, we're there.
We're cool now.
Yeah, yeah.
But
it's a different word for me when I hang out with new people. And when they use it, I'm like, nice, now I know we can hang out.
Right,
right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, we know what word we're
talking. Huh?
What? We know your word.
Yes, guns.
Guns. How many more clips of this
one
craziness?
More clip.
Well, we still got 30 seconds on this one.
Oh,
craziness.
All right.
It's retarded. People would be going insane.
You know what?
And I don't like to use that word.
I thought of it, and yet you did, and it just rolled off your tongue like I've heard you say it a million times. If they would have said this, this would have really pissed people off.
Oops.
Cunty. My God, this is interior is as soft as a cunt. So get your cunt out to your local Chevy dealer. You're fucking nuts, dude. Seriously. You're not coming back. Wow.
He's right about the cunt thing. People would be outraged.
Cunty.
I think that would be a cool commercial, though.
That would be.
I would buy a car if the interior was soft as a cunt.
It's an attention getter, too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it is.
That'd turn your head to the TV in a second if you heard that.
Yeah. Did he just say it?
Be like,
he said it again.
What?
I know the auto industry is hurting a little bit, too. You want to come back.
Come back.
Get
strong.
That commercial out there
cunty
this
interior.
Sunday during football.
Detroit, I hope you're listening.
You'll have right. The whole world talking about your product.
Fuck rich Corinthian leather.
Right.
I want a cunty interior.
Right, absolutely.
Yes.
Soft as a...
As a nice cunt.
As a soft as a cunt.
I was going to say teen cunt. Jesus. Let's see.
We have one more clip.
All right.
Okay.
And in this clip, Fez suggests what word they could have used instead of crazy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
If the joke of the commercial was they keep using the same word over and over again, you could have used anything. She could have just kept using the word awesome over again and could have gotten corrected on that.
Corrected how?
I said fantastic. I thought you were going to say awesome. It would have been the exact same
gosh.
Joke of this dull commercial.
Didn't Toyota use awesome in their ads years ago?
Awesome.
Probably, we are driven.
It offended really cool people.
Yeah, I guess so.
You realize that there were no human beings that were mentally deficient or challenged in this at all, right?
Yes.
It was just two people saying that this deal is so good, it must be unreal, i.e. crazy. That's how we have said. These are crazy prices. Prices so low, you're going insane. You've never gotten furious about these commercials before.
See, I think that's the same excuse as saying that's so gay and saying, no, I didn't mean it in a homosexual way.
And I'm looking at you now, and your eyes are not fixating on me. They're rolling back and forth.
Oh, my God. Shit.
I don't know what they're doing with your meds, but the paranoia is gigantic now.
Holy shit.
And where are the mental health groups that stuck up, that went after Burger King in their commercial?
This is not even fun. He's insane.
Because
he doesn't even listen to what Ronnie's saying.
No, Ron.
He just keeps, like, he's got the point. He's going to just, like, over and over again say the exact same fucking thing.
Fez Watley come cruising. You look into his eyes, he doesn't even seem to be thinking. Till they roll over white.
This is so off the rails. I want to think it's just a silly bit.
It's not.
I know it's not.
You give him a counter argument, And instead of either countering that or saying, you know what, you're right, I didn't think of it that way.
No, he doesn't.
He goes back to the first thing.
No, he doesn't hear the other side of arguments. I'm insulted because the commercial just is, who gives a fuck? They should be able to do better than that.
You wouldn't even think of that commercial.
Or it'd be fun if the twist was, you know, they say crazy a lot, and then, you know, the last shot is a fucking lunatic in the back seat.
In a straight jacket.
Yeah, it would be funny. I would laugh my ass off at that.
It'd be good.
Like, look what they just did.
You watch football on Sunday, right?
I actually watch the Red Zone now, if you need to know.
But they probably aired that commercial. You probably saw it.
I didn't see it. I have not seen that commercial.
Maybe you saw it and it just didn't register.
And they're saying Western New York, so it must have been during the Bills game.
But that commercial was so nothing that I'm sure everybody saw it.
I guess.
You and just forgot.
You wouldn't give it a second thought because it's so nothing.
Didn't realize you even saw it.
Right.
And I'm affected by crazy in my own life. I don't give a fuck.
Didn't register.
No!
Any more of that?
I give a fuck that a crazy person could easily push me into an oncoming fucking subway train.
That's true.
That's what I give a fuck about.
Yeah, I don't like crazy people with bricks in their hands.
Right.
Now you're just saying that against crazy Americans.
We had some dude with a pipe, yesterday, right? Where was that?
Yeah.
You tweet about it. Brooklyn?
It was in Brooklyn. Some guy decided to just beat someone with a pipe.
That's crazy. I'm more worried about that type of crazy. Actual craziness.
Real crazy.
Affecting, you know, my life, which it has.
That motorcycle gang?
Yeah.
They drove that guy in the Range Rover crazy.
Oh, that guy was crazy.
He drove over them.
Sure.
It's crazy.
Let's get past this, because I'm just annoyed. What's left with this?
We just got to finish this clip.
All right.
And where are the mental health groups that stuck went after Burger King in their commercial, but not this one?
You pause while I talk, but you don't even respond to me.
Wow.
It's like I'm not even here.
See?
I'm just, I don't know what to do anymore. I don't know what to fucking do anymore. Phil, you're on the Run of Fed show.
Yeah, I was going to say the crazy thing is how that was shoehorned into a mid-SNL conversation.
Yeah, what started this bit? Did you say something was crazy? Did I say something was crazy?
You said something was crazy, and that made it go off in my head.
Well, why aren't you furious with me, then? Why don't you ever stop me and say what you just said is offensive? I'm sorry. That wouldn't mean you respond to me.
I said we shouldn't use those words.
I'm going to use it all the time. I'm going to fucking use it more than ever. I want you to talk to your shrink and come back. They're fucking filling you with some kind of pills that are making you nuttier rather than less nuts.
Holy shit.
Crazy is not a good place to be.
No, and that's what I'm saying about this commercial.
I'm telling you, forget the commercial. I'm telling you, you're on the edge somehow. This is insane talk.
Wow. Wow, Ronnie really digging in.
You know, the lack of acknowledgement that Ronnie's even trying to, you know, educate him or make a point is what's really crazy about the situation.
Crazy.
That's craziness.
Whew.
When you don't listen to the other side.
At all.
You don't have to agree, but at least acknowledge you just heard the guy
the guy's
talking
argument.
To you.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh. Like he's not explaining. He goes, what makes this different than this? Mm-hmm. And there's just no acknowledgement that question was posed.
No, then
just
it just
moving forward.
Reiterates the opening salvo.
And Jocktober is off and running.
Wow. That was bonus Jocktober from the Run of Fez show.
And this would have been brought to the show regardless of what month it was, because this happened yesterday, and Travis and me are sitting in the office going like, what the fuck is going on?
Right.
Has Ronnie ever gotten that adamant about
it's rare.
Being a little off kilter on something?
It's very rare.
I'm going to have to listen now today. See the follow-up.
Yeah. All right, well. Follow-up.
Yeah, there's probably, you know, they'll probably talk about this.
What?
About our acknowledging Fez doing the commercial. And
well, now we have to worry?
No, Fez will be worries. Mad at me. You guys don't have
whatever.
To worry.
Whatever. But now, whatever.
Because
whatever.
You decided to cut it up and bring it to the show.
Why would anybody think to do that?
No, we were absolutely going to bring it up because our Twitter's exploded.
Mm.
Our peeps are out there.
Either way, if that
with
conversation
their ears to the ground.
If that conversation happened on any radio show, especially on this platform, especially on this channel.
Right.
Yeah.
We'd have grabbed it.
You have to.